Texas cop found not guilty for negligent homicide. Here's the video, then I'm gonna explain what happened.
Hello? Are you okay? Is that your dog? Can you get back? Oh, 243 shots fired. Ma'am, get a hold of your dog.
He said, ma'am, get a hold of your dog. He has shot the woman. He shot the dog's owner. Put up his picture. This Texas cop has been found not guilty for negligent homicide. What I saw was negligent homicide for sure, at least negligent homicide. He recklessly attempted to shoot the dog and shot the owner. I'm gonna give you background to all of this. Former officer Ravi Singh shot 30-year-old Maggie Brooks to death during a welfare check in August 2019. I want you to think about this for a moment. During a welfare check, he ends up killing the young lady. Arlington Police Department official killed that young lady. Tarrant County Jail is where he was initially incarcerated. That's the mugshot. Tarrant County jury found this cop not guilty of criminally negligent homicide. Brooks' father, his name is Troy. Let's put up Maggie Brooks. Let's put a picture up. Okay? Her father, Troy, told CBS 11, he doesn't know how anyone could come to that decision. Saying, and I quote, there's nobody that owns a gun that would ever take that shot, ever. But if you're a police officer, you're covered in absolute immunity. You can do whatever you want and there are no repercussions for you. Now, I want you to be reminded of something. Because I know some are going to say, especially those that support law enforcement no matter what, well, he made a mistake. He was in fear of his life. It was an unfortunate tragedy. That's why he was charged with negligent homicide. Because intent is not required in negligent homicide. That means that you did something that was so reckless that you knew when you did it, it possibly could have this impact on somebody else. That's all it takes. Doesn't take intent to murder. He was charged with negligent homicide and found not guilty. I'm going to expose what the DA said about this. Let's put up Ms. Brooks' picture again. The woman that he killed, Ms. Maggie Brooks, she was a mother of three. She was actually possibly homeless at the time of this killing. She was often seen walking with her boyfriend and her dog, a lab mix who weighed about 40 pounds. Brooks' family have now filed a federal civil rights lawsuit against the former officer. They're seeking $2 million in damages. Singh, the cop, was just a month on the job in 2019. Just a month on the job in 2019 when he responded to a call to check on a woman sleeping behind a shopping center. When he found her, her dog charged at him and he fired his gun. The bullet ricocheted and hit Brooks in the chest. In the cop's defense, he was trying to help when he faced a threat from the dog and it was a tragic accident. An expert witness for the state pointed out that the cop knew there was someone in the direction he was pointing his gun, but he fired anyway, ignoring his training and ignoring basic firearm safety. Now remember who testified? An expert from the state said what this cop did was reckless. What this cop did violated his own training. And what this cop did violated the basics of firearm safety standards. But still found not guilty. In November 2019, amid an administrative investigation, the cop decided to resign from the department And in September 2020, a county grand jury indicted him for negligent homicide. Let's go to the DA. The district attorney, her name is Sharon Wilson. The DA's office released a statement. Now, before I go to the statement, there are some things you're not going to hear. You're not going to hear that this is an unfortunate conclusion of the jury. You're not going to hear the jury got it wrong. Here's what the DA's office said. A jury heard the facts related to the death of Ms. Brooks in 2019. They evaluated the testimony and evidence and determined that the cop was not guilty. By doing so, the jury fulfilled their duty in the criminal justice system, as did we. That's it. That's all. As I've said before, reform in policing is not just for black folk. It's not just for brown folk. It's for all of us, because we're all in this together. And the sooner we realize that we are all in this together, the quicker we can absolutely create remedy and reform and also replacement when necessary. But as long as we believe that somehow these things would never happen to us, that while that's tragic, that it never happened to my family or me, as long as we continue to hold that ideology, as the sentiment goes, when they knock on your neighbor's door and you say nothing, who's going to speak up when they knock on yours? Ben, thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, there's really a million layers to this. First and foremost, obviously being homeless, right? Like, she's not seen as this perfect victim. And that's a big problem in our society. And then there's just this reality that is that juries are very reluctant to condemn police, especially when they know what the conditions are in our prison system, which maybe perhaps is a good reason to change our prison system at its core, so that maybe juries will be a lot less likely to let police officers like this off.